Hello, my name is Alex, and in this video I'm going to show you key assistant script in action. I want to demonstrate the Pickwalk section of the script and how to use it in practice with this particular rig. The Pickwalker name is self-explanatory. I have assigned desired controllers of the rig to the script, and at this point I can pick any controller, and with help of the script buttons or assigned hotkeys, I can literally walk on them in any direction by switching selection from one controller to another. All of this you can see on the demo of this script. The link of this demo you will see in the description of the video. But in this video I want to show you a much more faster approach, which allows you to navigate on the controllers with help of the mouse wheel. I want to pay your attention to the fact that this is only one specific approach. You can use it as is, adjust it to your preferences, or just forget about it if you will see too much disadvantages of this method. So let's go forward. We have desirable controllers assigned to the script and hotkeys assigned to the pickwalk buttons. I don't use the mouse wheel rotation for the camera zooming, since for me it is not precise. I always use right mouse button for this purpose, and I have remapped these rotations to the pickwalk hotkeys. In my case, wheel rotation to the up is equal to pickwalking in up direction. Rotation to the down is equal to pickwalking in the down direction. Wheel rotation to the up with shift pressed is equal to pickwalking to the right, and wheel rotation to the down with shift pressed is equal to pickwalking to the left. You can use any software that allows you to remap the mouse wheel to the custom hotkeys. I use the Autohotkey software, since it's fairly simple and flexible enough for this purpose. I have attached the Autohotkey file where you can remap the mouse wheel to any hotkeys. Notice that F1 will pause the remapping. It was done since this code detects what window is active now. If Maya is active, remapping will work. If another software is active, remapping will not work, avoiding unpredictable key pressing. But this line means that code will detect appearance of entire Maya window. And if I decide to scroll in attribute editor or in outliner with the mouse wheel, it will not happen because remapping will work. So for these cases, F1 will pause this code manually. You can convert this code to the executable file in order to use it in any computer that has no AutoHotkey installed. And you can move the shortcut to the AutoRun folder if you wish. Another thing I want to show you is how to reveal hidden controllers in order to pick any controller and start walking in any direction. Firstly, you can hide it here. My very advice is to prepare your character. Assign all joins, clusters, locators and all this stuff to the layers and hide these layers. You can also assign all meshes to another layer and change the layer mode to reference. Also, you need to leave controllers editable. Now, if all prepared, you can assign attached script to the hotkey press and release. Don't use Ctrl, Shift or Alt buttons with this hotkey for the script, since these buttons will add or delete objects from the current selection or rotate the viewport. I have assigned the slash key, since it is the rightmost unused key on my keyboard, which is very handy for the frequent using of the script. Now you can reveal all controllers with the hotkey pressed, and while hotkey pressed, select one or many controllers and start walking on the controllers. At this point, you can concentrate on the animation process with hidden controllers, which is very handy for seeing your character silhouette clearly. Now I'm going to show you in a real-time speed how it works. Hope you like it. If you find this script useful, you can visit my website, where you can find this script and other Maya scripts as well. I wish you best of luck and happy animating!